she was holding her Shih Tzu, and I was like, "Your Shih Tzu, your Shih Tzu is the boss." I mean, I said, "She's my boss." All right, I'm gonna use a 10 blade. Matter of fact, you know what? Let's just pull out the 7. Let's see what the 7 will do for us. You get this hair on you, man, you are gonna have splinters. It's really thick. And white is like a white car. You're gonna see it's real clean or real dirty easy. You're also gonna see the lines really well on a Westie, so. So how you come and hold your blade, if you create a line, you're gonna have to erase it later. So be careful and just do it right try to do it right the first time. It's real hard, like right there. There's probably a line right there I gotta fix now. But try to do it right the first time. So you don't have to come. There's another line right there because he keeps moving his head. Stop. I'll have to fix that. I might have to fix that. I knew I had this black brush. He was sitting on it. So as much as I like the 7 blade, the hair grows all different. And so it's, you can see here, it's a little shorter than here. And whatever I call out, you're probably gonna be like, "Yeah, you did that." You know, no. Stop. So you can see how the hair is. And so the 10 would take it down just shorter, and I would like the 10 better. It would be less choppy. Now, if you want a show dog groomer, if you want breed-specific grooming, you should ask for that. But she's been going to Petco and PetSmart, which makes sense to me because that's where I learned. I learned how to groom at PetSmart. And we've done a lot of 10 Westies. So here we go. We're going to do the 10. And the hair is really thick. And I need a sharper blade. This one's not going to work for me here. It needs to be clean, the cleanness of a clean cutting blade. So even though this is ceramic, I can tell this is a little bit more dull than a different blade of mine. So I need to switch blades. And let's see how it goes. Much better. Much better. You can see. This is much better there. You know, I'm starting to think that maybe it's hard to get the angle because he's sitting down. Like it's trying to get a fade while somebody's looking up. on a human head. So you got, now we've got to get him to stand up. I mean, this is, we've got to do, be able to get that pattern in there, right? Are you shivering? Don't shiver. Don't shiver. No, no. No, no. Look up. No, no, no. Look up. I see, look up. Nope, not yet. Not yet. Wait, wait, don't do that. One thing I noticed was that the drum loop is actually pretty loose, like not really loose, but loose enough that he's like able to, looking around is okay, moving his head is okay, but to have that extra little gap right there, let me just tighten it up a tad bit. Don't. Just a couple minutes here, not even an hour, just real quick now. Let me just set this pattern up, and then you can do whatever you want. Wait for it. No. You just gotta stand up for like 15 minutes. No, no. Come on now. Up. Wait. Thank you.
gap, bro.
Stop. 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 Put your foot down. Well, hey, stop. Well, I might have you turn around again. Go ahead, bud. I do need you to stand up. You do need you to stand up at some point, like on your own. Oh. Stop, stop. I think what you're trying to do is slip over here so you can sit down. Wait a minute. Wait. You won't get to sit. When I'm done with you, and for the next 3 months, you can sit. Okay? Trust me, ghost, you will be able to sit. I promise you. Ready? That's good enough. Check your heat, we're good. Let's do the ears. Oh my goodness. What? Clothing is really hairy. Wait, wait, wait. You're right, you can sit down right now. Don't. Let me see, please. Wait. You notice he's looking the other way, right? Don't do that. Don't. Hair everywhere. I mean, like, everywhere. Like, there's hair everywhere, all over my little prickles, everywhere because of the static. Look at my clipper. No.